You know, we've known for a while now that people who have diabetes are more at risk for severe illness from coronavirus. Now, some new studies show a possible link between that severe COVID infection and new cases of diabetes. So, what does it all mean? We're talking it over with Dr. Peter Montgomery, family medicine specialist at SSM Health Group in Wentzville. Good morning to you, doctor.
Hi there. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. All right. Are people with diabetes more susceptible to contracting COVID in the first place?
Absolutely. Diabetes inflames your arteries. And what we're finding out with COVID, it's an artery irritating disease that then affects many organs, mainly the lungs, but also the liver. People get a lot of brain fog, the loss of sense of smell, is some nerve damage that takes quite a while to come back in some people. So we're finding it's an artery disease, and people with diabetes, their arteries are already inflamed from the diabetes. What we're finding is a lot of people don't know they already have diabetes. They were borderline, and this stress pushed them over the edge.
So why are we seeing people who are newly diagnosed with diabetes, they end up getting sicker if they get COVID?
Well, I mean, because they're already a bunch of kindling ready to catch fire, and then, you know, the COVID comes along and it's the match. People who know they have diabetes are usually already watching their diet, which is the main treatment. They are on medication that is modifying it and calming it down. And these people come in and stressed out. When you're stressed out, your body makes steroids. We found that giving steroids, especially dexamethasone, cuts the death rate by about half. So we're adding steroids, and their sugars shoot through the roof. And part of the article is just to let doctors, hey, no, this is happening. Undiagnosed diabetics are coming in. Our treatments, which is helping with COVID, is making their diabetes worse. They may need more insulin, and we need a higher level of clinical suspicion for new diabetics.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question. COVID interferes with the diabetes treatment. What about down the road, once the COVID hopefully is gone? How does your diabetes treatment change in that regard?
There is definitely a lingering effect from COVID. Again, everything's inflamed. It takes a long time for inflammation to come down. I have several patients we keep on low steroids even for up to a month to, you know, get things finally calmed down and get them off oxygen. But then we get into the standard diabetic care. The mainstay is diet, exercise, awareness, educating the patient. The modern medicines we have now, the metformin and some of the once a week injectables, are amazingly better than previous medicines. We actually are trying to get people off of insulin. Initially, you'll probably be on insulin to get the better sugar control. But the real name for diabetes should be known as insulin resistance. Just shouting insulin at people who are deaf to insulin doesn't really work very well. So we'll just see your family practice doctor, see your endocrinologist, your internal medicine doctor, and we'll get you on the standard treatments for diabetes, which the goal of all treatment diabetes is to get you off the medicine by improving your lifestyle.
Yeah, and of course, all the necessary COVID precautions to go with it. So thanks so much for joining us this morning, doctor. Some really great information. And for our viewers, if you'd like to learn more about diabetes and COVID, we've got a link for you on our website as well as our Fox 2 mobile app.